Thank you, sir. Friends, let us recognize formally and consciously that innovation is key to survival. Since primitive days, humanity has been engaged into it. That is why we are here. We don't innovate, even day-to-day survival, we would not have been here. The second fact which I would like to share with you, particularly with the youngsters, India stands 86th in the rank of innovation index. This is a hard fact we have to bear. And undisputably, it has been established that the innovation has a great linkages with the GDP and GNP or soundness of any economy. Korea is innovation one, Canada, Norway, they are all high ranked, and you can see there's a great correlation and positive correlation between two systems. Therefore, Center for Innovation in Public Systems as an institution is playing great role, and I am honored to be here and sincerely grateful to Mr. Chakravani, Rao Garu, that they have given me an opportunity to be with you and share some of the innovative practices which me, my group and my organization, National Informatics Center, has been engaged for the public good, along with the state government, along with the government of India, along with panchayats, along with urban local bodies, all wings of the government in public life. So I will have opportunity to share specifically, but let us recognize and again appeal to the youngsters, create something new. Create something new using IT, create something reusable, and that is what this institution, this workshop stands for, and I'm sure you would have made great contribution to the country. March forward. Good morning once again, ladies and gentlemen. The morning session I shared with my core thoughts that innovation is key to survival, and this framework is one of the such product born out of such core thoughts. Service Plus is a framework. It is a metadata based integrated service delivery framework. We call it metadata because it's a configurable, it's a single unified, configurable. It can be used anywhere, anytime, by any level of the government. It can be used by land department. When I talk about government, we dissect further, and in government peculiarly, we have three kind of organs, the land department, the panchayats, and the urban local bodies. Though they are also, as morning session said, they are government, like a state government, central government, we call them local government. The operational URL of this is serviceonline.gov.in, and there is a demo installation also which can be used for training hands-on. Now, what is happening today? Why this initiative should be categorized into classification of innovation? NEGP, Government of India, has a plan, National E-Governance Plan, which focuses on ICT infrastructure and which focuses on quick service delivery to the common man. There are various attempts, the initiative, and I will not get into the detail. Three key projects are E-District, E-Nagarpalika, and E-Panchayat. E-Panchayat focuses on automation of panchayat and service delivery to the common man. E-Nagarpalika envisages on automation of urban local bodies, corporation, municipality, town panchayat, town areas, and service delivery to the common man. Third is E-District. So whatever portion of the governance remains with the line department after revolution, that need also to be automatized, and that services which are to be rendered by the line department falls into area of E-District. But fortunately or unfortunately, the line departments as on today, line departments is state government, They are more strong, they have more functions, they have more powers. So E district has got a lot of weightage and push is being given, because devolution is at varying degree happening in various state government. And the, some like state like Kerala and all have a lot of devolution, where panchayats are playing key role, Karnataka, West Bengal, Tripura and Kerala. While others, still the state government is doing a lot. Now many state government, I think by now 12 state government have brought their own Service Delivery Act. So currently, I'm just giving you a scenario quickly so that we are all positioned at the same level. Earlier services were given, you go for birth certificate, death certificate, whether you'll get it in 5 days, 10 days, 15 days, there was no ceiling of the time on that. So if the new awareness generated by NEGP and in, charging of ecosystem have forced the state government to bring out Service Delivery Act, wherein for each services they have declared that I will give this services to common man in 5 days, 10 days. It's a liberty of the state government. Some of the places they are giving birth certificate in 30 days also, but that's a choice. The governments have been asked to make explicit statement that you will get it in 30 days. That's it. So the citizen knows that he has to get it. So these are called service labels. So this has been one of the outcome, and please don't minimize it. It's a big statement. It's a big statement. Just 5 years back, we did not have this. We did not have. You apply today, whether you will get it or will not get it. And once the service label came into the force, automatically the penalty and rewardment system follows. And that also has come because of these acts. These are the development which has been happening. So every state government is engaged. Andhra Pradesh has done commendable work. More than 150 services. Niseva is popularly popular concept which has been going on. And Government of India also bringing Apex bill called Electronic Service Delivery Bill. From where? But the state government like Madhya Pradesh took very early initiative and became the pioneer in rolling out a Service Delivery Act. Okay. Rapid advancement into ICT, as you are aware, web, Twitter, public media, social media, they are all bringing new approach to the contacting and making inclusive government possible. So what is happening right now? Every state has to deliver some set of services they have identified. So birth certificate, death certificate, residency certificate, caste certificate, social benefits and so on and so forth. So every state needs a software. So there is a mad attempt going on with the help of NIC, my own organization, or without NIC to develop the software. So ultimately what you can visualize, the student community particularly, that there are going to be 30 modules of birth certificate. One running in Andhra, Tamil Nadu, Kerala, Karnataka, Leh, Bihar, Nagaland. Everybody will have birth certificate. Everybody will have death certificate, residence certificate. So if one state has a 30 services minimum on an average, let's take average because Arunachal has only 5, Andhra has 150, the Madhya Pradesh has 170, that kind of thing. So take 30. 30 services on an average and 30 modules for each services, 900. And take 5 lakhs cost for each software maintenance. Because government keeps changing the business logic, government keeps changing everything. So every time, whether it's done by NIC or non-NIC, software development modification cost has to be there. So if you multiply 900 by 5 lakhs minimum, it goes into crores. And that you keep spending. And you be dependent on, the second adverse effect is, that you take time in developing software, you test it, the software, you have to security audit the software, it undergoes a different line, so you try and take, because political system doesn't bother about, they suddenly chief minister or the minister concerned will appear, see that 50 more services will be done. It's a race right now happening. 50 more services now, poor software development agency has to bear the pressure and somebody's life will be optimized and he'll be working day and night in software development to meet political commitment. This is what is happening, and it involves huge expenditure. We have been watching this at Delhi. We have been studying. So we take a took the cognizance of this scenario, and we said, why can't we have a single software which can be configured to meet majority of need, if all needs, if not all needs? And this product is born out of those attempts, that learning which we acquired from many places. The second ill effect of that, in Andhra Pradesh also, pardon me sir, before some time, now integration is happening, you had a AP Online, you had a Me Seva, you had different portals, and similar situation, if situation was existing in Andhra, it was existing in other states, much worse. The citizen did not have one place where he can go that, look, I am XYZ, my age is 45, and my social standing is like this, what am I entitled for? Because different systems are being created for service delivery and they don't talk to each other, their metadata are different. Because they may be done by different agencies even. Their codes used in the village, panchayat, village, block are different, so they can't talk to each other. The logic is hard-coded. They're not configured. They are customized system, logic is hard-coded. So another problem, that citizen did not have a single portal. To now the states are like Andhra is now converging everything and trying to build one portal, which again is costly. So we thought of generating a single portal. There should be a software which can be configured by concerned line department. Today all these attempts are spearheaded by IT department, another noticeable. So there is a centralization of service delivery within the state government. So if panchayat service has to be delivered, they have to approach IT department. If the anybody's service have to, so entire burden of the responsibility of business logic, if anything fails today, it comes on IT department and the concerned department, agriculture department will not be concerned. Because he has given entire business logic to IT department. And IT, because it's a technology centric. So while we are trying to demystify the service delivery, within the state government, state IT is getting centralized. And IT means technology. So it is again becoming technology driven. It should be concerned line department driven, but they can't do it because they may not have IT manpower, they may not have IT understanding, so they are banking on central the departmental IT. We tried to undo this, that let's give a simple interface to each state government. So if there is a service of the soil testing or a pesticide or something and vaccination request, it should be handled by the concerned health department or agriculture department. They should define their service. They should own their service. They should change the business logic. They should reduce the payment charges. Why should they contact IT department? The thing must devolve first urgently. Currently, all service portals, they are all done by, we are not taking cognizance of 73rd, 74th. So any level, today if a district wants to deliver a service which is applicable, only let's say in Rayalaseema, why should they come to the state IT and say that this service is applicable only in a particular district and please do something for me so that I can do within? They should be able to do it there only. If there is a Mandal Panchayat who wants to deliver a service within their Mandal Panchayat, today it is not possible because again they have to have either software development unit or be dependent on the state IT.
Is it not there in the Mandal headquarters?
Pardon? Software development facility is to the required level, it is not there. You may develop software, then you do security audit, then you many more things. So they invariably land up either at NIC headquarters or state IT or district people. And they give their understanding, this is need of my service, please develop the software. There's no tool where they can configure on the fly and they won't put online their service without knowing anybody else. They are responsible for it. So we noted down all these. We also studied a great number of services across the country and we tried to see the variation in services. It's a birth certificate. In how many possible ways the birth certificate can be delivered across the country in 30 states? And what changes possibly can occur? So we did this study which made possibilities, a combination of possibilities, the universe of the possibilities. And then we design the architecture of this innovative systems. Then, along with the service, you have public grievance. State have defined public service delivery gate. For that, you don't develop another software. You should have a generic software. So you should be able to configure the public service delivery policy also, grievance policy also, kiosk management. There are places in where kiosks are involved in public service delivery. Take Chhattisgarh, take Jharkhand, take Kerala. This, the states are in Andhra Pradesh also, some of the services are delivered through kiosk. Okay. Kiosk facility is there. It's based on, my introducer was telling me that he doesn't understand, probably. multi-tenancy. Multi-tenancy can be defined with the two hardcore parameters. If the single software, single instance of software, installation of software can help variety of users without changing the code, this is first condition which can be truly can classify a product as a multi-tenancy. So this framework can be used by citizen, kiosk, franchise, ULBs, line department, state government, and within these many kind of users, definer, creator, contributor, stake, process flow players, all kind of thing. Same source, I don't change the source code, I don't change the different installations. This is the first and foremost condition. Second, it should be able to run on cloud. Third, you should be able to give it as an application service to the people. You don't charge them in case it is charged. You don't charge them for software development. Whatever need comes, you meet them, and you may have built-in criteria for payment and charging facility. That's a separate issue. So this is a fully SaaS application service. It's a multi-tenancy. That is why multiple tenants in the same instance. It's called tenants. Various tenants can use the same software. So it's a new jargon in the international IT vocabulary, multi-tenancy software. Are you multi-tenant? Are you cloud-enabled? So if you say I'm multi-tenancy, it's a one answer which satisfies many things. It can be configured by each tenant as per their need. It's open source based, it's a Unicode-enabled, normal IT facilities. It's a 2D barcode-enabled, it's a DSC-enabled. It has an interface with the payment gateway. Built in. So you say my service will require payment gateway, my service will require DSC at this stage, system will understand. You don't write any Java code. You don't write any programming. Just say yes, no, yes, no, yes, no, and it will be up and ready to deliver your service. It's that kind of, it can also integrate with the backend. So if you have a BPL database behind and you want to check, some of your service wants to check whether the applicant is BPL or not, it can talk to the backend database, which you may have a separate database. So there is a web services based interface which has been positioned. It can talk to CSC Valet, it can talk to NSDG, and you can build in. Today what is happening? People are applying, sir. People are applying for services, but the clerk concerned decides. He has got 20 applications, he may select one 10th application. In majority of applications across the state, there is no policy. We have built in FIFO. So if state says first in, first out, the clerk will be able to see all the applications unless he clears the first one. And he has to take a decision whether he's possible set of decision which is entrusted to him. Either he forwards it to somebody, either he rejects, either he approves. He has to take call on that. He just cannot keep sitting on that and entertains the seventh application, eighth application and makes him to wait. So it depends on the state. We don't write a separate software for it. Just he says enforce FIFO policy and the software will go accordingly. It has support online, primarily online, and pardon? By the concerned definer, who is launching the service. He must tell his condition that my application will be received by panchayat, then tehsildar will do this, but do process flow, and he say that everybody will follow the FIFO. System will not allow any process flow player to jump on the queue. Then there is a discretionary facility also. Sometime in an emergency, you need to, he may go to the collector and get the permission. So that permission is also there. There is one person who is in charge of that service is given liberty to jump. And he can jump the queue. He can only jump, but the lower level clerk will not be able to. So these are, and this is all without writing the code. Whatever I have said is without writing code. Tomorrow if you decide, the concerned department says that I want Mishra to try out my service, just go on to the demo site, take user ID, password, start defining, and you are up and running. E-District has defined some of the scenarios, okay, where there are majority of departments. Leave aside Andhra Pradesh. Andhra Pradesh is a green state of IT. I mean, let's go to the other side. I mean, leave aside southern Indian state for that matter. Kerala, huge level of automation has happened. Andhra, Tamil Nadu, Karnataka. But please come to the Uttar Pradesh, Bihar, Rajasthan, where majority of the state government do not have IT systems in place. Forget about online. Offline is not there. If you walk little northeast, things are further difficult because of terrain, because of literacy, because of IT literacy particularly. Literacy is better there, but there are other issues. The Service Plus can be used by such department for end-to-end job. It can act to some extent, some measure as a backend also. If they have a backend which is offline, then it can talk to them. It can talk to them using technology interface. There are things, if they have online, then also it can talk to them. So these are three, four scenarios where it is possible. How did we achieve this innovation? How did we are today able to offer a menu where I don't give any service, I give only building block for a service. And it is the definer, it is the launch, it is the agency who uses these components which are on the screen to define a service. So you have a beneficiary profile, every application, every service we have recognized that will have a beneficiary profile, which will go on to the define entitlement. Then you will have an application submission process. It can be personal, it can be online, it can be by mobile. Then your service charges may be zero, maybe 5 rupees, maybe build on a criteria, maybe for SC, ST. So you need to build a combination. Then you have payment mode. If there is a payment, then you may accept the money through a draft, through check, through net banking, through debit card. There are many ways we have built in all. So you just keep ticking that this is the mode in which my payment will be received. Application form. Today, what happens in majority of system, application form is uploaded in PDF form and it lies on the website. Service delivery is different. People download a form in offline. If they are changing the business logic of application, every time the developer has to remember, I have to change the form also. Otherwise, form becomes obsolete, and when it comes filled, system rejects it. That form purana tha and the system has changed. There's no such possibility in Service Plus. The form gets generated. You can design, but you use the same parameter in designing the application form also. So there is an editor. You can design your good form aesthetically using the variable which play a key role in service delivery. You have workflow. So this is another component. Then you have certificate generation. So birth certificate, death certificate, all those layouts can be generated and printout can be taken, digitally signed. You have grievance redressal, kiosk management, service delivery. These are the core components which play invariably an important role in any service delivery. And we have taken cognizance and we have made these reusable components where you have to pick up and plug. This is the architecture of the overall, how it interacts with, so people can, a citizen can come to the state portal, they can code directly on Service Plus portal, okay. And it has a middleware, again it can talk to NSDG, via NSDG to backend or via the web services. Both the options are open. So the sum and substance is any innovation must reduce the effort in terms of money and time. Service Plus does that. Any innovation which does not reduce these two things fails miserably on the count. Rapid enabling features. And if I learn a feature from Nagaland, I built in here, tomorrow it becomes available for everybody. So that is another feature. So it's a common body of knowledge. It is not owned by NIC. It is learned and accrued from the country across. So even when you define a service, if you define yourself, defining it last, what is the name of the service, local language name and all, is it a G2C, is it a G2E, G2B, all kind of categorization, is it primary, derived, and what is the standard defined in ETAL, then mode of submission, what kind of enclosures, what kind of photographs are required, two require, four require, in pair, for marriage certificate, in pair, all possible questions for a service is asked. And there may be some possibility that there is something missing, then we take the feedback, we improve it further. But today, we have operationalized 21 services of Maharashtra, 2 services of Chhattisgarh, and 1 service of Kerala. And Kerala has taken a decision to operationalize 600 services using the same. Yesterday, a second one was launched in Kerala. Because they tell us the condition, we tell them user ID, and they define, and they are able to up, and they are able to test it. So time to go up is hardly 1 day or 2 days. I mean, time you take in defining And I don't do anything. They don't contact Delhi. They do it their level. In case they have a problem, then they contact us. Otherwise, they have to do, they define, they are responsible, they test it, they certify that yes, I am satisfied, all the tests are positive, and I want to launch the service. Service charges based on beneficiary profile or charge distribution. Then you have online, cash, check, payment mode, certificate, reports. There are services where cash is only involved, social benefits. There are sometimes certificate is given to the people. There are sometimes both can be the problem. Cash is also given and certificate is also given. So all kind of, then there is a service where kind, the gold coins are given. Okay, there is a service in Tamil Nadu where Chief Minister gives the certificate to the Kumari Yojana or something like that. Then the food grains are given as a part of service, they apply and then you get it. So we have all kind, all possibilities built in a service. It is the definer, it is the department who has to define, not IT department, it's a concerned department.
Kinds have become more, actually.
Pardon?
Kinds have become more.
More, now kinds have become more, absolutely. And then you define the application form, certificate layout, intermediate forms. So in process flow, currently if you look at the software, and what I'm saying is I'm making considerate statement. I've seen all softwares which are working, at least from NIC, 8 to 10 states. Process flow player will say forward, reject, but if he has to write some comments, those things were missing. We took cognizance. So every process flow player, like in file, he writes that because of this reason, I am not able to approve this certificate. So we are giving intermediate forms also. And then grievance redressal, you can define. There are two kinds of failure and the grievance is lost in two across the country. Either failure of the service or deficiency in service. Failure means service at all is not given. And the deficiency means service was given, but the shortcoming in the service. Probably the certificates were torn, probably it was not readable, those kind of things. Okay, so both and most of the Service Delivery Act has analyzed and made provision for these kind of process. There is a first applied authority, second applied authority, then tribunals are in place and the designated service officer can be penalized for it. Or he can also go and put up his defense that this is the condition under which citizen can register. He has been given a personalized space. He can register, he can maintain his certificates achieved so far and he can reattach. He need not have produce and scan another certificate. So he has a bank of certificate. And if the time limit is applicable, let's say in some of the state, I won't name it, the birth certificate is given only for 2 months. So after 2 months, you have to again apply for it. Okay, these, just to generate the revenue. Okay, or maybe some other reasons, I don't know. There is something which is educational purposes. Residency certificate is given in three nature. If you want to apply for admission within the state, within the district, one certificate, within the state, another certificate across the country. If you want to go, a person from Maharashtra, let's say, or from Kerala, he wants to apply in Bihar, then he'll be given a third kind of. I'm unable to, we are requesting such states, please go through the BPR. Why? I mean, there is a state where birth certificate application form has a 4 pages. And the mother's date of birth is also included in the birth certificate. No reason. I went up to Chief Secretary, sir. He says, no, it is as per act and we need to now revise the act. It has been hard-coded. So I'm telling you, in manual system also there are problem of hard-coding. Since it was put in act and legislature has approved this, executive order cannot change it, so they have to go back to the assembly to undo it. But because it has been a neglected area so far, now IT systems need yes and no very clearly. And then these kinds of things are getting revealed. 4-page application form for birth certificate. Fortunately, Andhra has reformed everything and that is becoming as a best practice to other states also. We show them that please look at these are the things which you minimum require. Otherwise they think that I am from IT person background and I am suggesting. I am telling another state government has done it. You please consider they are also state government and they have same bureaucracy. So you have a dashboard. These are some of the screenshots which are there. I am close to my presentation. I am just giving you an example. Sanitation service and Chhattisgarh services are through Gram Panchayats. So Gram Panchayat gets it. So Gram Panchayat data, if you go on to the onboard serviceonline.gov.in and go for summary count of report, you will see roughly I think 25,000 services have already been rendered and the pendency level can be monitored, the form can be designed, and you can define service. These are, I mean, interfaces of the software. Define charges, all kind of charges based on the profile, based on the geography. You can also, state can also define that this is the service I am defining only for the Andhra region or for Telangana region, part of the region. I shouldn't be naming it here, but in other state, let me be more cautious. Let's say some coastal services there for fisheries in Kerala, which is not applicable to the mainland district. So you can define those kind of combinations are possible, or you can define that Uttar Pradesh is defining, let's this is applicable in all 72 districts of Uttar Pradesh, that also you can do, or you can say Western UP. So any combination in terms of geography can also be done, okay. And you can define the breakup of the charges, accounting package is also there. These are service charges, I'm just skipping one screen, I wanted to show you the process flow. Process flow creation, submission. So you can have, you see this one. So forking of the process, one clerk may forward an application to two clerks, and two clerks further can bifurcate to four clerks, and again convergence may happen. So entire forging, convergence has been taken care of. Any complexity in a process flow, it may not be linear, I forward to you, you forward to him, him forward. There can be branching at some stage, all those things have been taken care of. I think I will pause here for question answer, see, but let me submit again. I'm not here talking about software. Anybody can make the software. I'm talking about innovative thought, innovative practice, which has gone through in conceptualization and making it available to the country and the people. Thank you.
Thank you. Before I throw open for any clarifications and questions, he has summarized ably the single uniform grievance redressal as well as service provision concept using an architecture. Both for governance, both at the district level and at various levels, district, municipality, as well as panchayat levels. It has also elaborated on the methods of inclusive governance and convergence. And he has also expressed a problem of coordination, separate different portals for the same purpose. And he said there's an increased demand on the system depending upon political promises. And they also talked about the IT as a technology-driven force and emphasized on simplification of records. Talking about software as a service, I have a small suggestion. There's a need for generating services not only among the providers of different services, but also in a milieu of the general public where there is a lot of illiteracy, as you rightly said, ignorance and apathy. How to dovetail this high technology based IT services to simplify, to reach the common man so that they can get the services in a meaningful way. Now I throw open this discussion. We've got 10 minutes. Anybody who wants to seek any clarification from you?
I've seen in papers. So, any services it is providing free of cost to the government or as of now?
Grass, it is meant for to be used by the government. It's a free of cost. So, any level of the government, urban local body, panchayat, or state government, or central government can use it. It's an initiative started under NEGP and it's made for the use of the government. It's a free of cost to the government. Yes.
Convergence is not there, is not yet established that the
village level, not the federal level, the village level. So how would that
This is a good question. We have been, a lot of IT systems, some in substance what he's saying is, a lot of IT initiative, e-governance initiatives are happening, but the people may not be aware. So a lot of extension work has to happen. Remember 1969, some of the people, my seniors are sitting, an agriculture revolution was happening, Dr. Swaminathan, lab to land. The extension program was launched so that the farmers could know about the new implements, new crops, new seeds, and all the same situation is happening today in 2010 to 2013. We have built in excellent systems. There is one part of the country where connectivity is not there. There is another part of the country where village level connectivity is there, but still people are not aware. So a lot of extension program for the Panchayati Raj. See, you can't do anything at the village level if you don't involve, you can't do much at least, unless you involve Panchayati Raj institution. That is the place where the difference between ruler and ruled gets blurred. So a lot of extension, some substances, sir, we have to have a lot of extensive extension program on e-governance, without which, because you may publish anything on website, Twitter, blog, but poor villageman, he doesn't have access to this, and even if we have an IT kiosk in the village, he doesn't know these things exist. So we have to have a digital literacy program so that he starts his indulgence with the internet and come to know that these facilities have been made by the government.
Let me just clarify one thing. You know, the MeSeva services in Andhra Pradesh are while now quite well known in the villages. We have about 7,000 MeSeva centers, which are called the common service centers.
Yes,
I have gone to villages, found out to find out whether they are available, number one, and whether the villagers know. By now, it's certainly catching up. I agree with Mr. Mishra that a lot of effort is to be made. That is the reason why I am saying that these 2.5 lakh gram panchayats, which are going to be connected with high-speed broadband, should be made use of by all the departments, including the revenue, rural development, education, health, animal husbandry. There is a collector who has also started rolling out veterinary services through some of these things in Madhya Pradesh. So it is possible, provided all of us decide to propagate, number one. Number two, through a legislation, through quasi-judicial, quasi-legislative measure, there has been electronic delivery of services which has been done in the state of Andhra Pradesh.
Yes.
So you cannot go to an MRO's office and get a caste certificate. You have to necessarily go to the MeSeva center. But that is by legislation, forcibly. But the question you are raising is spreading awareness. Absolutely right, sir. We need to do that.
So it's a pull, push, a stick and carrot. And the core part is that still we have 60% people population as agriculture in our country, and the services meant for that agricultural occupationist are not there. We are making birth certificate, death certificate, which he hardly requires. These are required by the people who are seeking government service or multinational services and those kind of visa, passports and all. He requires soil testing, he requires consultancy on crop fertilizer, he requires RKBY, he requires different kind of scenarios, and those services are not available. So if we make it demand-based services, people will come to know. If there is a demand and he is looking for that, this is the soil of my land, what kind of fertilizer, what kind of seeds I should be growing, he will come to know, don't worry. But we have to find out those services. So we must do need assessment. We have done right for 95% services are urban-centric services. We have to change the paradigm to cover the 95% of rural population. And for that, we have to change the booking. Thank you.
Sir, may application on the rapid rollout can be configured by themselves if they will not come to the technical team for any configuration?
So Maharashtra has done 21 services already rolled out. You go to the URL, you will see the nature of those applications. And Chhattisgarh has rolled out 2, and Kerala has rolled out 2. And
what are those services? Can you please?
I don't remember 21 services name, but they are all same nature. Birth certificate, death certificate, all residency certificate.
DIT is taking a rapid rollout initiative and they have assigned the CGG EPAS is the first project to be taken under rapid rollout, and we are also working on that to make it a productized rapid rollout shape so that any state cannot come to a service provider, they can straight away go to the cloud and it can be kept in an app store and they can just make it and configure themselves and they can use it straight away without contact in the technical
service. Folks, sorry, E-Pass is only about scholarship. Here, I am not hard-coded for scholarship. Any kind of service, any kind of, it could be birth certificate, birth registration service, any kind of service where people apply and there is a process flow and there is an output. As long as these three things are there, you are most welcome to use Service Plus on the fly. You can see the list of services which Maharashtra is using available on the portal. Yes, last, you were asking something.
Just to recap on the points which you mentioned about the SaaS model and the process flow, you know, do we have a library, component library where other departments can use it instead of reinventing the wheels every time?
We have reusable component of library which is being used for panchayat. I mean, this is Service Plus is one of the product member of a panchayat enterprise suite. So we have developed ERP. Somebody in lunch tea was asking that why don't we, somebody from Bihar was asking that why don't we have the ERP for government? Because my answer to him was that processes are not a standard. It's not like the Fortune 500 companies where you have a SAP, you have SAS, you have BAN, you have Marcel. But their processes are very standard. In government, a lot of discretionary functions are there. For the same kind of situation, we may say yes to one, we may say no to other. So in such a situation, IT systems can't do because a lot of discretion is given. But for panchayat, taking these variations in cognizance, we have developed a panchayat enterprise suite where these reusable components have been used. Service Plus is one of the member of the panchayat enterprise suite. And at software level, we have library of reusable component, which I showed you, the list, beneficiary profile, payment, DSC, sign, this, that. So we have a library. If somebody wants to use, or somebody wants to take it, they are available. Within NIC also, whenever we do this kind of thing, within NIC, we broadcast. And within NIC, we don't reuse majority of time. We use majority of time, unless very exceptional situation is there, then we develop. Other than we take benefit, so we build upon.
There is a
center called there is a website called App Store. Current Secretary Satyanarayana Garu initiated a concept. There is an appstore.gov.in where all reusable product which can be downloaded or on the fly can be used. So their details are available. Appstore.gov.in.
Thank you, Mr. Mishra. Thank you very much. In view of I know there are a number of other questions, but you can ask them in private if you like. Thank you very much, sir.
My email is dcmisra@nic.in. You're most welcome to write. You do write your background, small line, whether you are a student or you are with the government, which department, and query. I'll be happy to answer. Thank you.